Are you sick and tired of having too many emails in your inbox? Well, one of the simplest things you can do to reduce email clutter is to create a filter. So in today's video, I want to show you everything you need to know about creating filters here within Gmail. I want to show you how to create them. I want to show you how to edit them and even delete them if something goes wrong. Hello, everyone. Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity, helping you to get more done and enjoy less stress. And one of the things that we need to remind ourselves is that not every single email needs to start its life here in your inbox. You probably receive a number of emails that are still of value to you, but you don't need to necessarily see them as soon as they come in. I'll give you a quick example here. I've got a few different newsletters here at the bottom of my inbox, which are valuable to me, but I don't need them to appear in my inbox. Ideally, I would like them to bypass my inbox and go to a label over here on the left so I can go and review them once in a while, maybe once a day or once a week. It's going to help me with my email management. So let's get started. In order to create your filter, what you can do is come up here to the search bar. Now, don't let this fool you. It is so much more than just a search bar. And in fact, we want to come over here to the right and select this down arrow. Now, we've got a variety of different options as to how we can create a filter. Perhaps one of the most common ones is to filter by email address or addresses. We can include multiple email addresses here in the from line. We can also just include the domain name. So for example, we can include @google.com, and now every email that has that domain name at the end, @google.com, could be filtered when we create this. Of course, we can also filter by the to email address if there are certain words in the subject line, or if the message itself has certain words or doesn't have certain words, we can do so as well. Now, a few of these criteria here are a lot more specific to the actual search, such as the size of the message and the date range, for example, as well. But even though that this search button is highlighted here in blue, you can see here that we can create a filter as soon as we start including criteria. But I want to show you one other way as to which you can create a filter, and this is particular to our example here with a newsletter. I'm going to actually open up this message. This is the one that I would like to create a filter to. And instead of me having to copy and paste this email address, all I need to do is come up here to these three dots, this more option, and I'm going to select filter messages like these. By selecting this option, the email address is automatically brought into the field. So it's already there and waiting for me to continue. Now you can see that this create filter option is available. Now, if I just want to search other messages that are from this sender, well, I can do this at this point, but I want to proceed and create a filter. And if I need to, I could always add other criteria. But in this example, I just want to send these messages somewhere other than my inbox. So at this point, I'm going to select create filter, but don't worry, the filter isn't actually created. It's going to give us now the important decisions we need to make as to what is going to happen with these messages. So at the very top, I think is perhaps one of the most important ones, and that is skipping the inbox, or as we see here in parentheses, archiving the message. So by checking this box, what's going to happen from now on when this sender sends me a message, it is not going to appear in my inbox. It's going to bypass my inbox and go to where I tell it to. By default, it's going to archive that message so I can go see it, I can go search for it and review it, but we're also going to add a special label in this case. The second one is also important depending on how you manage your email. Mark as read. If I check this box, it's automatically going to mark these messages as read so you don't have a large number or a large list of unread messages. But be careful, if you do this, you may not know which ones you've laid eyes on yet or not. So I'm going to actually leave this one unchecked because I do want to see how many of these messages will be waiting for me. Star it is the generic Gmail star, which will appear beside that message. I'm going to leave that unchecked here. But here's another one we're going to use in our example, applying a label. So by checking this box, I can come over here and select either one of the labels that I've already created. But don't worry, if you want to create a new label, you can do that here as well. So I'm going to select new label. And in this case, I'm going to call this one newsletters. Okay, I'm going to give it the name newsletters, and I'm going to say create. So I'm actually going to be using this label in the future for a variety of different newsletters that I may receive. A couple of the other options that we have here are to forward it or delete it as a part of your filter. We can say never send it to spam. So maybe there's something that sometimes gets caught in your spam folder. You can actually say never send it to spam. So if you want to protect a certain email address, you can also use templates. And if you'd like to learn more about using templates here in Gmail, I'll include a link in the description below so you know how to do so yourself. And a few other options here near the end. Always mark it as important. Never mark it as important. We can also categorize it by choosing a category. And these categories are the standard ones from Gmail. We cannot create additional ones, but things like primary social updates and that type of thing. And then the last one I think is also perhaps one of the most important. That is also apply the filter to 5 matching conversations. So for example, we don't want to just apply this filter to the message that we're dealing with here. We also want to, or I should say, we don't want to apply this filter to just future messages. I also want to apply this filter to the messages that are waiting for me here. I can see that there are 5 messages here. I also want them all to be applied to this new label. So at this point, we can now hit the blue create filter, and you can see down below those MindMeister emails are no longer here. One was read, one was unread. It doesn't matter. We wanted to apply it to all of those messages. If I go over here to newsletters, remember, this is the label that we just created. If I open this up, now all of these newsletters are waiting for me. I can deal with them. I can read them whenever I like, and they are no longer crowding out my inbox. And remember, going forward, they're never going to enter my inbox. They're always going to come here. And I can continue to reuse this label for future newsletters as well. Now let's take a look at another example with when it comes to creating filters. And this time around, we want to highlight things within our inbox. So unlike the first example where we were bypassing the inbox, we want these new messages to remain in the inbox, but we want to highlight certain messages. So in this case, I'm going to use these 3 Scott Friesen emails as an example. And let's pretend that this email address maybe is my boss, for example, or someone very, very important. So I want to highlight these messages. If I have a large number of messages staring back at me in the inbox, I want to quickly and easily see these messages first. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select one of these messages. It's probably, again, the easiest way because it's already going to pull this email address. I'm going to come up to more and I'm going to say filter messages like these. So there we have the email address already there waiting for us. Again, I could add or change other criteria if I want to, but I'm going to continue on to the create filter option. Now here, I'm not going to select skip the inbox. I want to keep it in my inbox. Now I want to highlight this, and there's a few different ways I could do so. I could add a star to it if I want to, but you may have this star feature apply to other things as well. So in this case, I'm going to say apply a label. And once again, I can choose something that is already there, but I want to say something a little more specific. So once again, I'm going to select a new label, and I'm going to say urgent, because if this is my boss or a very, very important client, I want this one to stand out. So I'm going to say urgent, and I'm going to select create. So now this label was created, as we see here in the bottom left-hand corner, and that label will be applied. Now there's nothing else here that I am going to check. I guess for safety, I could say never send it to spam. Okay, so it's never going to send to spam if it's my boss's email or someone that I really want to highlight that is really very important. And I'm also going to say apply this filter to the 13 matching conversations. Now I'm going to say create a filter. So now if we go back to my inbox, you can see that this label has automatically been applied to these three messages. And now going forward, any message coming into my inbox is going to have this urgent label applied to it. But you know what? By default, when you create a new label, when you're creating a filter, it's just going to use this generic sort of gray. It's almost a dark gray on a light gray. It doesn't stand out quite as much as I would like it to. No problem. All I need to do is go over here to the urgent label itself. I'm going to select the more option and I can come up here to label color and I'm going to pick this white on red. Yeah, that stands out a lot more. This is going to get my attention and see when those messages hit my inbox. So this can be a great way to highlight certain messages, especially if you're not bypassing your inbox and you want them to see them right here within your main screen. Now, last but not least, we sometimes make mistakes or maybe we just need to edit an existing filter. In order to do so, we need to jump into settings. So here I'm going to hit that gear icon, and then I'm going to select See All Settings. And about the fifth option over is an area called Filters and Blocked Addresses. So at the very top of the screen, you can see the different filters that I have applied to my account. And we can see these last two are the ones we just created. Here was that newsletter one for MindMeister, and here was this urgent label that I wanted to apply to this particular email address. Now, if I want to make a change to any of these filters, all I need to do is come over here and select Edit. By doing so, it's actually going to bring us back to this search screen, this search slash filter screen, where I can add different criteria and change it. I can hit continue, and then I can come to this dialogue and say, oh, you know what? I forgot to hit this never send it to spam folder. That's what I wanted it to do. I'm going to say update that filter, and now that filter will be updated. And in a similar vein, if you want to change one of your filters and just remove it altogether, you can come over here and select delete. Well, I hope you enjoyed today's video and got a lot of value out of it. If you would like to watch more videos on how to get more out of Gmail, I would encourage you to click on the playlist down below. And if you want to watch my latest video right here on the Simpletivity channel, check out the video in the bottom right. Thank you so much for watching, and remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.